historical perspective on the art of violin playing since the beginning of the recording era. Jascha Heifetz, Part 5. What is the miracle of Heifetz's art? What is the secret of his phenomenally perfect technique? In the early 1920s, the New York music critic Max Smith had a discussion with Heifetz's teacher, Leopold Auer, about Heifetz's magic. Heifetz had carried me away by his marvelous technique and the beauty of his tone, but he had appealed rather to my intelligence than to my heart, said the critic to Auer. Well, responded Auer, he took you out of yourself, didn't he? You heard nothing but the music. You thought of nothing else. That's true, said the critic. Well, then, Auer concluded, he did all that you should expect. The phenomenon of the genius's art can hardly be explained because the substance of the subject is in the mysterious power of the genius's mind. In the performing arts, a genius artist hypnotizes the audience by using his instrument as a medium for delivery, for projection, and for imposing his intellectual and mental power on them. Heifetz's ability to store nervous energy to its full capacity and release this energy at the time of performance is incredible. His power of concentration could only be compared to that of Albert Einstein. Speaking of the physical aspect of Heifetz's playing, coordination between his arms is absolutely perfect. He achieves a maximum economy of motion. It could be said that the efficiency of his playing is 100%. On the instrument, there are two points which receive tremendous amounts of energy. One, where his finger touches the fingerboard, and another, where his bow, which is like an extension of his arm, touches the string. His arms, as strong as steel, are at the same time incredibly flexible. Even in the fastest passages, each finger, after touching the string, makes a spring-like recoiling action in the first knuckle. As a result, we hear the crisp, clear execution of every single note in any combination of passages, in any tempo. The intensity of his vibrato makes his tone so opulent and penetrating. Now we present the fantasy on the opera Carmen by Bizet, written by Franz Waxman especially for Heifetz, in a 1946 recording with the RCA Symphony Orchestra, Donald Wuris conducting. That was the fantasy on the opera Carmen by Bizet, written by Franz Waxman for Jascha Heifetz and recorded by him in 1946. Chaconne for violin solo by Bach from Partita No. 2 in D minor is probably the most monumental work written for the violin solo. Heifetz recorded the Chaconne three times, in 1935, 1952 and 1970, and each of these recordings bears his own signature. It is not his perfect technique or the beauty of his tone which is so striking. No, he is not just playing. He is building a great palace, a palace with the perfect proportions of an ancient acropolis. We can almost visualize it as a great piece of architectural art. Chaconne from Partita No. 2 in D minor by Bach. Jascha Heifetz in a 1952 recording. Thank you. That was Chicon for violin solo from Partita No. 2 in D minor by Bach, performed by Jascha Heifetz in a 1952 recording. This concludes the fifth part of our program dedicated to the greatest violinist of the 20th century, Jascha Heifetz. Today's program is part of a series of programs entitled An Historical Perspective on the Art of Violin Playing Since the Beginning of the Recording Era. My name is Yuri Beliavsky, and I wish you a very good day.